And so Sue Hutchings, ladies and gentlemen, the Department for Environment and Water, she will be doing a welcome and an overview. Big round of applause for our beautiful sister, Sue Hutchings. Yes.
All right. Thank you, Kevin, for your introduction. And thank you, Kyla, for your wonderful welcome to country. So I too would like to pay my respects to and acknowledge the deep attachment and connection to the land on which we meet today. So it is a pleasure to welcome here this evening Narrangeri Aboriginal Corporation Chief Executive Bill Wilson, Mayor Keith Parks from Alexandrina Council, Mr. Richard Beasley, South Australia's Commissioner for the River Murray, who we will hear from shortly, Kylene Maywald, South Australia's Water Ambassador and former Minister for River Murray and Water Security, and our friends from the Goyder Institute for Water Research, including Director Dr. Alec Ralston, who have very kindly hosted us here in their brand new Koorong Lower Lakes and Murray Mouth Research Centre. And we're really excited about the new research projects that will be delivered in this region. So I'm very pleased to welcome you all here tonight on behalf of the Department for Environment and Water to celebrate a very significant milestone for a very special program. Tonight, we celebrate 20 years of the Living Murray program and the Lower Lakes, Koorong and Murray Mouth as an icon site. The Living Murray is one of the longest running river restoration programs in Australia. It was established in the early 2000s in response to widespread ecological decline across the basin's rivers, wetlands, floodplains and estuary. The program is primarily about returning water to the environment, often through the use of water management infrastructure, and then monitoring and adapting so we can get the best outcomes out of every drop of water. Tonight, the outcomes of the Living Murray program will be shared, detailing the early recovery of water for the environment, how the water is being delivered to the Koorong and Lower Lakes, and how the ecology of our wetlands is changing. As you'll see, we have a full agenda tonight with presentations from Jews water managers and some of South Australia's leading scientists. We also have two panel sessions where you will have the opportunity to ask questions of the presenters and other experts. This program is also about people and partnerships, and the 20-year milestone would not have been possible without the collective and dedicated work of many groups and individuals, including staff from SARDI Aquatic Sciences, the University of Adelaide, BioR, CSIRO, Flinders University, and the Murraylands and Riverland Landscape Board. Many of the scientists who are presenting tonight form part of our Koorong Lower Lakes and Murray Mouth Scientific Advisory Group. This group provides scientific advice to the department on flow management, barrage operations, and ecological change in the region. There are also many members from the Narrangeri community who have supported the Living Murray program over the years. Stephen Walker, Grant Rigney, Rick Hartman, Candice Love, Bill Wilson, and now Tanya Rigney. All of these dedicated people have added their own flair to the role of Yaluwarui Project Coordinator, resulting in many fantastic programs and events being run with the Narrangeri community. Jew would particularly like to acknowledge the leadership of Tim Hartman, Uncle Clyde Rigney, and more recently, Bill Wilson, who have guided many TLM projects with the support of Kirsty Wedge from Jew. The department is also incredibly grateful for all of the Narrangeri community members who have worked with our scientists to help collect data for our long-term monitoring programs and the Narrangeri Aboriginal Corporation's cultural monitoring programs. Our staff are always impressed by your ability to don a pair of waders and fearlessly grab a huge yabby or a thukabi, and your generosity in sharing your knowledge and culture. Lastly, there are some special guests here tonight who have travelled from the Riverland in South Australia. A big welcome to the Chowla Icon Site Community Reference Committee and Chowla TLM staff, and it's wonderful that you've come to support your fellow TLM team. The Living Murray has been such an important program for the department and South Australia over the years. It paved the way for basin plan implementation and the further recovery of water across the Murray-Darling Basin, and it has been foundational to ecological improvements and river restoration. On behalf of the department, I would like to thank everyone for all of your valuable contributions to the Living Murray program and Lower Lakes, Koorong and Murray Mouth icon site. And I hope you all enjoy the night. And I will now hand back to Kevin.